to now in this series, we've been using the privileged user that was created when we installed the operating system. I've added some new users with the add user command, and this creates home directories for the users. And I've added two users because we're going to look at two different methods to make the standard users privileged users. The first thing I'm going to do is open a new terminal by clicking on File, Open Terminal, and I'm going to use the light profile that we created back in video 2 of this series. In this terminal, I'm going to switch to the Mary user with sudo su Mary. And I'll go to her home directory with cd and print that out with pwd. I'm going to try and view the root directory as Mary with ls-lah/root. We get the permissions denied error, so I will add sudo ls-lah/root. And here we see that Mary does not have privileges to view the root directory. To make Mary a privileged user, I'm going over to the other terminal where I'm logged in as the Michael user, a privileged user, and I'm going to make Mary a privileged user by updating the sudoer file. To update the sudoer file, I will type sudo vi sudo. And notice that the vi sudo is all one word. It is not vi space sudo. It's the single word vi sudo. And pressing enter, and this takes us into the sudoers file. But notice on this Ubuntu-based operating system, we're using nano and not vi, even though the command is vi sudo and not nano sudo. We want to add the Mary ID to this file, and we want to add it right below this line here, this user privilege specification line. So I'm going down to that. And that line itself, user privilege specification, is just a comment. We see that hashtag on the left. That means that this is a comment. Below that, we see root all equals all. That's giving the sudo privileges. I'm going to press enter and add Mary right below root. And the rest of this line, I will just type the same thing. All equals left paren all colon all space all. And I'm using all uppercase because they're using all uppercase for the root user. I want to save this, so I'm going to hold down control and press X to exit, and then Y to save, and enter to not change that file name. Now let's go back over to the other terminal where we're logged in as Mary. I'm going to press the arrow up and enter. We need to type in Mary's password again. Pressing enter, we can now see the root directory, showing us that Mary is now a privileged user. I'm going to exit out of Mary by typing exit. And I'm going to log in as the George user with sudo su George. And I'm going to go to his home directory by typing cd and then pwd, and we see that we are now in George's home directory. I'm going to clear the screen and try and view the root directory with ls-lah/root. Permissions denied, so we'll add sudo ls-lah/root. And we see that George does not have privileges to view the file. I'm going back over to the other terminal where I'm logged in as Michael, and I'm going to add George to the sudo group. I know we haven't talked about groups or file ownership yet, and we will be getting to that shortly. For now, we just need to know that adding George to the group sudo will make George a privileged user. First, let's look at the groups that the user ID Michael has. For that, I will type ID. I can press enter here, or I can add on Michael. Here we see a list of groups that the Michael user ID is in. The one that we're interested here is sudo. This is the group that will give us access to run the sudo command. Note, if you are using Red Hat or CentOS, instead of using sudo for the group, they use the wheel group. And most likely that name wheel comes from someone who is a big wheel or someone important. We are not using a Red Hat-based release here. We're using a Debian Ubuntu-based release, so we are using the sudo group. If you don't know which group your distro uses, you can check that in the sudoers file. I'm typing sudo, vi, sudo. And we see right down here, allow member of group sudo to execute any command. Now we also see above that, members of the admin group may gain root privileges. That admin group is only there for backward compatibility. We are going forward and not backward, so we want to use the group sudo. I'm going to exit out of here without saving anything by pressing Ctrl X. And I'm going to add George to the sudo group with the user mod command that we have seen in previous tutorials in this series. I'm typing sudo user mod, then a dash because these are options, and an A for append, then the uppercase G for group, and then the group name that we want to add the user to, which is sudo, and then the user ID, which is George. He should be added to the sudo group. Let's check it out by going over to the other terminal. I'm pressing the arrow up, sudo ls-lah/root. Password for George. And we see that George is still unable to view the root directory. The problem is George needs to sign out and then back in to update the root privileges. So I will exit out of the George ID with exit and then go back in with sudo su George and go to his home directory so there's no confusion on who we're at, cd. PWD, we are in the George home directory. We're logged in as George, and I will type sudo ls-lah/root. We can now view the root directory, showing George has root privileges. In the next video, we will continue looking at the Linux command line.